Welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on light sensors. My name is Alex Bendar-Young, and I am an applications engineer at Texas Instruments. We previously discussed how different types of light sources have different spectra. In this video, I will explain how the human eye sees different spectra of visible light and why this is an important consideration for light sensing. The human eye focuses light through a lens onto the fovea, which is at the center of the retina. The human eye contains two different types of photoreceptors called rods and cones. Rods are spread around the outside of the retina. They are used for sensing brightness, specifically in lower light conditions. They are achromatic and cannot distinguish between colors. On the other hand, cones are concentrated at the fovea and are responsible for seeing detail in well-lit lighting conditions. They can also distinguish between color, as there are three different types of cones. For this video series, we will focus on how the human eye perceives brightness, so we will not discuss the different types of cones or color vision further. The human eye perceives the intensity of different wavelengths of light differently. This is shown in the plot on the right. The plot is a spectral response plot, which is similar to the spectral emission plots of light sources that we saw in the previous video. The difference is that this plot shows the responsivity of the eye to different wavelengths of light rather than the wavelengths of light emitted from a source. In well-lit lighting conditions, the human eye has a response called the photopic response that is characterized by the response of the cone receptors. Scotopic vision is the response in low-light conditions due to the rods. The scotopic curve is shifted to the left and towards the shorter wavelengths when compared with the photopic curve. It also has a higher overall response because rods are more sensitive than cones. There is also a transition area when the light is high enough to register the cone receptors but low enough not to saturate the rods, shown by the mesopic response on the plot. In this area, both rods and cones are active, and so the mesopic response is similarly a combination of the photopic and scotopic responses. Every human eye will vary in terms of the actual spectral response. The curves shown in the previous slide are from a CIE standard, which looks at how an average human eye will perceive intensity. Through a number of experiments, CIE defined the standard photopic response curve in 1924, which we will now focus on. This shows that in well-lit conditions, the human eye will be most sensitive to 555 nanometer light, which appears green. This curve also shows that as the wavelength moves away from 555 nanometers in either direction, the sensitivity of the human eye will decrease. This is the reason that the dot from a green laser pointer will appear brighter than the dot of a red or blue laser pointer of similar power. Recalling the spectra of light sources from the previous video, we can now use the photopic response to compute how the human eye will perceive the intensity of different light sources. This is done as shown in the formula by multiplying the intensity of the light source by the human eye response at each wavelength. Before integrating, this gives the light source spectrum weighted by how the human eye sees it. We see this done below with sunlight. We can also see how certain parts of the light source spectrum are diminished or completely rejected by the human eye response and other parts are enhanced. By integrating this to get the area under the curve, we obtain a single value which is correlated with the intensity seen by the human eye. The resulting spectrum from different light sources is now shown. We can see the fluorescent light source is still quite different due to its unique spectral profile. The other three spectra look quite similar from this perspective. As these are used for ambient lighting, the three artificial light sources are designed to emulate sunlight when viewed by the human eye. However, focusing on the shorter wavelengths of the visible region, we still see some differences in color. As we will see in later videos, perceived brightness is calculated by taking the integral of the resulting weighted curve, or equivalently, by summing the intensity seen by the eye for each wavelength. This means that the spectrum of different light sources can have a significant impact on the perceived brightness. For a visible light sensor that is trying to measure brightness as seen by the human eye, the spectral response of the sensor will need to match the human eye to give an accurate reading. For example, if the response does not reject wavelengths outside the visible region, then light sources that have different infrared or ultraviolet content may look the same to the eye and completely different to the light sensor. Here, we show TI's OPT-3001 ambient light sensor as an example. You can see that the response closely matches the human eye to maximize accuracy across different light sources. In this video, we have seen how the human eye perceives different light sources and the importance of taking the human eye response into account. In future videos, we will formalize how the intensity of light is measured and the units used to compare light intensity as seen by the human eye. To find more light sensor technical resources and search TI products, please visit the link shown. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Please try the following quiz. Question 1. What color is the human eye most sensitive to? Based on the spectral response plots, the human eye is most sensitive to the color green. Question 2. The brightness of a light source can change its color as it appears to the human eye, even if the normalized spectral characteristics of the light source remain the same. This is false. If a light source with the same normalized spectral characteristics is set to two different brightnesses, one in the scotopic and one in the photopic region, then the response of the human eye will shift. This means that the wavelength that looks brightest will be different. However, because rods cannot perceive color, the color of the light source will not change. Rather, for the dimmer light source, there will be no perceivable color. Question 3. What is the difference between the human eye response in this video and the plots of different light bulbs from the last video? Both the human eye response and the light source plots are spectral plots. They also both have wavelength as the x-axis, as is characteristic of a spectral plot. So far, we have only examined normalized spectral plots, so both were normalized as well. However, the human eye senses light, and so it has a spectral response, whereas light sources emit light, and so have a spectral emission. So the correct answer is C. Question 4. When using a light sensor for display backlight adjustment, what would be the best response? As displays are multicolored and pack many details into a small space, the minimum brightness setting will still need to provide enough light to operate in the photopic region. While the ambient lighting may become very dark, the sensor will be mostly active in adjusting the display under photopic lighting levels, so the photopic response is the most useful.